think music played a big part of it. My mum always says, you know, that what was lucky for us was that, you know, my career as a musician was just about taking off, or was just about to, when it happened. So there was a distraction. There was something that, you know, we had a separate thing to be excited about, because there was something that, instantly something missing in our house. And I think, you know, being able to be out and about and have things happening all the time and being busy was like a kind of like a lifesaver for us.
Loyle Carner is so genuine, and it is reflected in his ingenious music, honest and beautiful tracks. His sound has been described by Enemy as sensitive and eloquent and confessional hip-hop by The Guardian. He's a once-in-a-lifetime artist who reveals his life through his words. Benjamin Gerard Coyle Larner was born on the 6th of October in 1994 in Lambeth, South London. He was raised by his mum Jean and stepfather Nick. Carner went on to start university studying for an acting degree, but dropped out in 2014 due to his stepfather's death, which led to him focusing on music. His mother Jean is a massive influence to his music and his life. Speaking of his mum, Loyle said, "You've got to have at least one person you can chat to who doesn't have an ulterior motive." Loyle Carner's mum has featured on his own songs like Son of Jean and Dear Ben, a new song of his latest album, Not Waving But Drowning, a heartfelt poem describing Loyle and his life revolving around his mum. The poem goes on to describe the emotions that go through Loyle's life and how his mum helped him deal with it.
That is really, I don't know where you're from. I don't know what your DNA makeup is.
It's my mum, man. My mum's the greatest human.
Spoiler alert! Can you say that?
Yeah, for sure.
Spoiler alert. Your mum closes the album.
Yeah. In big style.
How long did it take her to write her, I was going to call it a verse, like a 16,
I was in the studio with Jordan Mackay finishing off the drums on Loose Ends, and I was like, I've got this idea for my mum, I'm just going to ping it to her, because it was getting close to her birthday or whatever, so I send it, and she stays in the car, and she calls me, she's like, I've been in the car for like, oh, I'm still crying, I can't get out.
Oh my god.
And I was like, I'll send you the beat, so I just sent her the instrument, and I was like, write something to it. So she just wrote it. The beauty of my mum writing that poem on that album was like, if she... you know, if you're a mum and you can't vocalise your emotions, but you feel like that for your son, right? So Benjamin Zephaniah, one of my favourite poets of all time, one of my heroes, and now a friend, he was saying to me, my mum can't vocalise her emotions. She can't explain it. First generation, she's come over, and she just doesn't have the language to say like how proud she is, but she is proud, right?
Yep.
And he was saying that this poem from my mum is how his mum feels, and so she can send it to him. And wow. God, this is how I feel. And so that I think that's the gift that my mum's given, is that you're speaking for all the mums who kind of go, oh, I don't know, I didn't study, you know, English language or go to school and study drama or do poetry or write songs. So I can't express it like this, but this is how I feel, you know? So that's a big gift for her to give to the mums of the world.
His latest album, Yesterday's Gone, was released in June 2019, which is again jazzy and intelligent. Loyle said, I had to do a lot of work on myself. I asked myself questions, some were scary and some were cool. He once again tackles very emotional topics like love, getting older and friendship. Loyle Carner continues to succeed with his nicest guy in rap character by creating a cooking school called Chili Con Carne. The school is open to teenagers years 14 to 16 who have ADHD. Loyle claimed he found solace in his music and cooking as an outlet to channel his energy and creativity. He hopes other young people will find peace through cooking, like himself. He said ADHD made him hot-headed, distracted, and cooking helped him channel this.
When you were a kid, you were diagnosed with ADHD.
Yeah.
How old were you?
I was like 7 or 8, I think. Young.
And that's quite young to like...
Yeah. I used to get in a lot of trouble at school, and my mum knew why. My mum is a teacher of kids with special educational needs, especially dyslexia and ADHD and autism. Yeah. And so she kind of knew what the deal was, because she'd seen it so many times before. And so I went to be assessed for it, and it turned out I had ADHD.
He started cooking at a young age due to an influence from his granddad, who travelled around the world learning a lot of different recipes, which were brought back to him. But cooking to Loyle was something that calmed him down, and claimed it provided clarity.
Yeah.
So you've got your cook school?
Yes.
When did you start that?
So I started that up. I think I started it 2 years ago. I started it with a friend of mine called Mikey, who runs a collective called Goma, and they just started like a social enterprise. They just help people set up what they want to do. And he reached out to me because he was setting up a skate park in Brazil, and he asked me if I wanted to be a part of that, and I couldn't because I didn't have the time for it, and I can't skate like I used to. So I was like, no, I can't really do that. But I'd love to set up the cooking school. I've wanted to do it for ages. So together,
it's funny. Like for me, what ADHD feels like, it feels normal because I don't know any other brain. You know, I'm just always switched on. I mean, it's exhausting. ADHD is exhausting, but it's also exhilarating. I think it feels exhilarating.
Loyle is clearly such a genuine guy, claiming he's never made a happy album, putting all his emotions into one album. He seems like one of the crowd, like a normal guy who has overcome his problems, using his hardships to potential to make beautiful and touching music. He stays to his word and hasn't changed, not even money. He's evolving hip-hop in an artistic way, unlike other mainstream rappers, and is an inspiration to all.
What is your big dream for your future?
Just to be happy, have some kids, get a bigger house, get a pool, continue to make music. I guess to be able to make music and for it to be heard by as many people who need to hear it, do you know what I mean? Not necessarily to like be the biggest, but just to kind of let the word spread as far as they need to spread, do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I guess,
be impactful to the people that really need it.
Exactly, and be the next James Bond.